In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, today the Church celebrates the memorial of Saint Paul the Sixth. He was the Pope who brought to completion the Second Vatican Council that brought about reforms in the Church. Let us ask the prayer of Saint Paul the Sixth that we too may always be open to renewal. To prepare ourselves for this Eucharistic celebration, let us humbly ask God's pardon and mercy for our sins. Lord Jesus, you raised the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you bring light and hope to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, who chose Blessed Paul the Sixth to preside over your whole people and benefit them by word and example, keep safe, we pray, by his intercession, the shepherds of your church, along with the flocks entrusted to their care, and direct them in the way of eternal salvation. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the first letter of Saint Peter. Beloved, realize that you were ransomed from your futile conduct, handed on by your ancestors, not with imperishable things, like gold and silver, but with the precious blood of Christ, as of a spotless, unblemished lamb. He was known before the foundation of the world, but revealed in the final time for you, who through him believe in God, who raised him from the dead and gave him glory, so that your faith and hope are in God. Since you have purified yourselves by obedience to the truth for sincere brotherly love, love one another intensely from a pure heart. You have been born anew, not from perishable, but from imperishable seed, through the living and abiding Word of God. For all flesh is like grass, and all its glory like the flower of the field. The grass withers, and the flower wilts, but the Word of the Lord remains forever. This is the Word that has been proclaimed to you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
Glorify the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion. For he has strengthened the bars of your gates. He has blessed your children within you.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has granted peace in your borders. With the best of wheat, he fills you. He sends forth his command to the earth. Swiftly runs his word.
Praise the Lord, Jerusalem.
He has proclaimed his word to Jacob, his statutes and his ordinances to Israel. He has not done thus for any other nation. His ordinances he has not made known to them.
Praise, Alleluia. Praise the Lord, Jerusalem. Please stand.
1, 2, and.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Son of Man came to serve and to give his life as a ransom for many.
Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
The disciples were on the way going up to Jerusalem, and Jesus went ahead of them. They were amazed, and those who followed were afraid. Taking the 12 aside again, he began to tell them what was going to happen to him. Behold, we are going up to Jerusalem, and the Son of Man will be handed over to the chief priests and the scribes, and they will condemn him to death and hand him over to the Gentiles, who will mock him, spit upon him, scourge him, and put him to death. But after 3 days, he will rise. Then James and John, the sons of Zebedee, came to Jesus and said to him, "Teacher, we want you to do for us whatever we ask of you." He replied, "What do you wish me to do for you?" They answered him, "Grant that in your glory we may sit one at your right and the other at your left." Jesus said to them, "You do not know what you are asking. Can you drink the chalice that I drink, or be baptized with the baptism with which I am baptized?" They said to him, "We can." Jesus said to them, "The chalice that I drink, you will drink, and with the baptism with which I am baptized, you will be baptized. But to sit at my right or at my left is not mine to give, but is for those for whom it has been prepared." When the 10 heard this, they became indignant at James and John. Jesus summoned them and said to them, "You know that those who are recognized as rulers over the Gentiles lord it over them, and their great ones make their authority over them felt. But it shall not be among you. Rather, whoever wishes to be great among you will be your servant. Whoever wishes to be first among you will be the slave of all. For the Son of Man did not come to be served, but to serve, and to give his life as a ransom for many." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Good morning, my dear sisters and brothers. The Lord must be very disappointed with his disciples, whom he considers friends. Because while he was saying that he will be put to death, while he was predicting what is going to be his passion and death in Jerusalem, his disciples, whom he considers friends, are talking about who is the greatest among them. Imagine your friends, you told them you have cancer, terminal cancer, and they say, "Oy, sa akin mo na lang ibigay yung mga kwintas mo, ha? Sa akin mo na lang ibigay yung mga ari-arian mo. So they were more interested in what they're going to get once you are dead. What would you feel? How would you feel? That is why I said the Lord must be disappointed with his disciples. But take note, the Lord did not scold them for being ambitious. John and James asked to be seated one at the left and the other at the right. That's greatness. They want to be great. They want to be seen as close to the Lord. Just like here in the church, we want to be said as close to the cardinal. No, oy, you're close to the cardinal, baka naman pwedeng. Close to the rector, close to the parish priest. The parish priest is his friend. The parish priest is visiting his house or her house very often on special occasion. That's greatness. Malapit sa pari. Malapit sa kura. But the Lord did not scold them for aspiring to be close to them, to him. But rather, he directed their minds to what is real greatness. What does it mean to be great? What does it mean to be up there in the top of the hierarchy? What does it mean? The Lord in the Gospel says, whoever wishes to be great among you must be your servant. Greatness means service. You want to be great? Good. You want to be number one? Good. But be number one in serving other people. Be great in serving others. That is the real measure of greatness. Hindi yung title. Hindi yung honor. In the church and in the eyes of the Lord, greatness is measured by how much you serve others. At palagay ko, yun ang gusto niyang ipaalaala. Hindi lamang sa kanyang mga alagad, kundi maging sa atin ngayon. Mas tumataas ka sa posisyon, mas nabibigyan ka ng honor, ng title, mas lalo kang dapat na maging lingkod ng lahat. Even popes, the popes are the number one in the hierarchy. But you know what one of the titles of the popes? Servus Servorum Dei, servant of the servants of God. Lahat tayo servants, and the Pope is the servant of us all. You see, the higher you become, the more you should be serving others. And in the eyes of the Lord, that is the measure of greatness. Let us pray for one another that we may not aspire for title or honors, but we must aim to serve as many people as possible. Amen.
Please stand.
Christ our Lord predicted his saving death and resurrection. Through him, the suffering servant, let us bring our petitions to the Father of all mercies as we say, Make us true servants, O Lord.
Make us true servants, O Lord.
That the leaders of the church may be true servants, acting with the same concern that Christ showed for his followers. Let us pray to the Lord.
Make us true servants, O Lord.
That the leaders of governments may exercise their power for the good of their people and avoid discord and distrust. Let us pray to the Lord.
Make us true servants, O Lord.
That we may realize that success in God's eyes is not measured by the standards of the world, but by the respect we give to our neighbor. Let us pray to the Lord.
Make us true servants, O Lord.
That those who are sick may realize that their suffering, undertaken in union with the suffering of Christ, can be turned into a great blessing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Make us true servants, O Lord.
That the faithful departed may find eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Make us true servants, O Lord.
Heavenly Father, help us to serve each other by imitating your Son who laid down his life for us. We ask this through Christ our Lord.
Amen. Please be seated.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. Through goodness we have this wine to offer. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. Please stand.
Pray, my dear sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Accept the sacrifice from your people, we pray, O Lord, and make what is offered for your glory in honor of Blessed Paul the Sixth, a means to our eternal salvation, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as on the festival of Saint Paul the Sixth you bid your church rejoice, so too you strengthen her by the example of his holy life, teach her by his words of preaching, and keep her safe in answer to his prayers. And so with the company of angels and saints we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints, including Paul the Sixth, who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you to your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
As one family with one common Father in heaven, we pray.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our many sins, but look on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. May the sacraments we have received, O Lord our God, stir up in us that fire of charity with which Blessed Paul the Sixth burned ardently as he gave himself unceasingly for your church, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My dear friends, we are again inviting you to join us in the Wednesday Family Rosary tonight at 9 p.m., which will be hosted by the community of Our Lady of Remedies Parish in Cebu, San Miguel, Bulacan. So join us via the Facebook page of the Manila Cathedral. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our Mass is ended. Go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Ipinagliling walang sala, puso.